if f is bounded on the closed interval a comma b and the set of points of discontinuity of f has a finite number of limiting points, then the function f is Riemann integrable on the closed interval a comma b. We shall now prove this statement. Proof: since f is bounded on the closed interval a comma b, it has infimum and supremum on the closed interval a comma b. Let us take infimum of f b small m and supremum of f b capital M. Let capital S equals to the set containing C1, C2, C3, so on, CP be the finite set of limiting points of the set of points of discontinuity in the closed interval A, B taken in order. C1, C2, C3, so on, CP be the finite set of limiting points of the set of points of discontinuity in closed interval A, B. Let epsilon be greater than 0. We enclose these P limiting points in P non-overlapping intervals A1, B1. This is A1, B1. By A2, B2, A3, B3, so on, AP, BP. That is, the first limiting point C1 is enclosed by the closed interval A1, B1. The second limiting point C2 is enclosed by the closed interval A2, B2, so on. The CP is enclosed by the closed interval AP, BP, such that sum of their lengths is less than epsilon by 2 times capital M minus small m. We call it as expression number 1. In each of the remaining P plus 1 sub intervals, namely the closed interval A, A1, the closed interval B1, A2, the closed interval B2, A3, so on, the closed interval BP, B, F has only a finite number of points of discontinuity because none of these P plus 1 sub intervals contains a limit point of the set of points of discontinuity of the function F. Hence, by a known theorem, namely, if f is bounded on the closed interval a comma b and has a finite number of points of discontinuity on the closed interval a comma b, then the function f is integrable on the closed interval a comma b. Therefore, there exists partitions P1, P2, P3, so on, P suffix P plus 1 such that 0 less than or equal to U of P or F minus L of P or F is less than epsilon by 2 times P plus 1, where R is running from 1 to P plus 1 because there are P plus 1 sub intervals. Let us call this expression as 2. Let small mr and capital mr be the infimum and the supremum of the function f in the closed interval ar, br containing the rth point of discontinuity cr. Therefore, there exists a partition P which contains the points a, b1, a2, b2, so on, ap, bp, b belongs to the set of all partitions of closed interval a, b such that 0 less or equal to u of p, f minus l of p, f is equals to this partition P consists of 2p plus 2 partition points. Now our aim is to show that for this partition upper Riemann sum minus lower Riemann sum is less than epsilon. Now our aim is to show that u of p comma f minus l of p comma f is less than epsilon. The subintervals divided by the partition p can be divided into two groups. The first group contains all the p subintervals given by expression 1 having p limiting points, and the second group contains all the p plus 1 subintervals given by expression number 2, and this group contains p plus 1 subintervals, and each subinterval contains a point of discontinuity. That is, p plus 1 subintervals and has p plus 1 finite number of points of discontinuity. Therefore, u of p comma f can be written as sigma r equal to 1 to p plus 1 u of p r comma f plus sigma r equal to 1 to p m r into delta r. The first subgroup contains p subintervals and having p limiting points, therefore r equal to 1 to p. Whereas the second group contains p plus 1 subintervals and it has p plus 1 finite number of points of discontinuity, therefore we are writing r equal to 1 to p plus 1. Similarly, we can write minus of L of p comma f is equal to minus sigma r equal to 1 to p plus 1 L of p r comma f plus sigma r equal to 1 to p small m r into delta r, where small m r is the infimum of the function f in the rth subinterval. The above expression is equals to sigma r equal to 1 to p plus 1 u of p r comma f plus sigma r equal to 1 to p capital m r delta r minus sigma r equal to 1 to p plus 1 l of p r comma f. Minus into plus is minus, therefore we write here minus sigma r equal to 1 to p small m r into delta r. Now we are going to have two groups, that is sigma r equal to 1 to p plus 1 u of p r comma f minus l of p r comma f plus sigma r equal to 1 to p capital M r minus small m r into delta r. We have already taken u of p r comma f minus l of p r comma f is less than epsilon by 2 times p plus 1. It is true for r equals to 1 comma 2 comma so on p plus 1. Therefore, the above expression can be written as less than epsilon by 2 times p plus 1. How many terms are here? How many sums are here? There are p plus 1 sum. Therefore, we write p plus 1. Since we have p plus 1 subintervals, therefore, while we defining u of p r comma f minus l of p r comma f, we are taken epsilon by 2 times p plus 1. So that this p plus 1 get cancelled. Now, coming to the second group, plus. We already mentioned that the p non-overlapping closed interval a1 comma b1 comma a2 comma b2, the closed interval a3 comma b3, so on, the closed interval ap comma bp, such that sum of their length is less than epsilon by 2 times capital M minus small m. Therefore, this sigma r equal to 1 to p delta r can be written as less than, that is, this is less than epsilon by 2 times capital M minus small m. What is the value of this sum? Sum r equal to 1 to p capital M r minus small m r. Its value is capital M minus small m. So that this capital M minus small m gets cancelled with capital M minus small m. Since the sum is capital M minus small m, for that sake only we are taken sum of their length is less than epsilon divided by 2 into capital M minus small m. Therefore, this p plus 1 get cancelled. This capital M minus small m by capital M small m get cancelled. That is equals to epsilon by 2 plus epsilon by 2. We know epsilon by 2 plus epsilon by 2 is epsilon. Thus, 0 less or equal to UPF minus LPF is equals to less than equal, hence less than epsilon. Hence, by the necessary and sufficient condition for a bounded function to be Riemann integrable is that the given function f is Riemann integrable, that is, this implies f belongs to R of the closed interval a comma b, that is, f is Riemann integrable on the closed interval a comma b.